Well, good afternoon and welcome to Wembley for the 70th Amateur Cup final, and maybe the last but one if amateur status is scrapped at the end of next season, as could well happen. But that's all in the future. What is certain about this afternoon is that we are going to get a new winners of the Amateur Cup, because neither of these sides have been to Wembley before. Well, now let's have a look at this Slough side from the Athenian League. They're the more experienced today. There are no fewer than seven internationals in this side. That's the goalkeeper and all of the back four. Goalkeeper Walton Hersham, back four of Reed, Darcy, Mead and Eaton. Plus the captain Day in midfield, plus Anthony of Wales at outside left, all the others of England. Well, now the Walton side, not so experienced, just the three England caps, Bassett and Smith in midfield, Connell up front. But a side that comes to Wembley with the enormous confidence of not having conceded a single goal in all the seven matches to reach this wonderful stadium. Good. Is it just John P? Are the North and Midlands taking this? Right. Right. Yep. Yep. And the colours, yep. Yep. Gets the 70th Amateur Cup final underway. Slough playing left to right, Walton in the all red. For those with black and white screens, Slough will be in the lighter shirts and the darker shorts. Well, both of these sides getting used to the wonderful turf here. Neither of these clubs have been here before, but four members of the Slough side have been here before, so they'll be looking to calm their teammates down. And it's Bassett there of Walton conceding the first corner kick, so first blow to Slough here. Roger Day, the captain, going over to take it. This is one of the six internationals in this Slough side. He's the captain of the side. A tool maker by trade, he'd like to make a good job of this first corner kick of the match. Oh, a nice little dummy there by O'Sullivan, but he didn't get the header in correctly, and Walton survived. Woofened it in there, not getting it away for Walton. Nice ball by Morris. Big Roger Connell. Easy to pick Roger Connell out. a big lad, long hair, number nine there, male model by trade. It's Connell again. Well, he's still got it. Gain in trouble there, and a good shot there by Connell. That was Roger Connell, the man who gets the goals for this Walton side. With the throw. Keith Mead. Was a nice ball there, nicely picked up too, and it's Anthony, Welsh international, but chuttered and slipped there, couldn't get it, and away comes Bassett. Nice ball. Walton calmly breaking out of this early pressure, and Connell again finding space and possession, already showing up strongly. Bit of a character, this lad, quite obviously. Male model, as I said, and not a man for conformity. He's got his socks down in, what, the first 5 minutes at Wembley. That's got to be some sort of a record. Meanwhile, it's Donaldson with the throw for Walton, the long one. Connell after it, but he was well cleared. A foul there by Connell on Roger Day. Day had dumbed him nicely, and Connell fouled him, and Harry Newell have a word with the big fella about that. For it well, and that was a bad one there by Bassett, and already this amateur cup final is cutting up rough, and Bassett will have to be spoken to about that. That's two members of this Walton side now already spoken to by referee Harry New. Well, for nobody does this match mean more than that man number five there, Alf Darcy, 38 years of age, 32 England caps, and he just made it for his fifth Wembley appearance, because he only passed the fitness test late yesterday. Anthony taking his man on, but not getting past Woffenden. Eaton with the throw. Anthony again finding good space, taking his man on, but he's hemmed in there. And it's a Walton throw. Roy Thomas to take it, to the youngest man in this Walton side. Again looking for the big fella, Connell, and Connell, oh, a good one indeed. This is Dave Morris, and a lovely ball, but just a little too far for Summers. Bassett's going to get another word from referee Harry New. Clearly Walton not taking any prisoners. They've not let a goal in so far in the Amateur Cup, and they don't want to let one in the final. Eaton with the free kick. Well, that's Roger Day fouling Smith there. Understandably, neither of these sides wants to let the other get the advantage, and so a lot of free kicks at this stage. They'll probably settle down in a moment, but at the moment, quite a lot of free kicks for an Amateur Cup final. Smith winning it strongly for Walton. Good ball by O'Sullivan. Day wants it from Eaton, but Eaton goes it alone. Dave Morris heading it away. Summers. Nice ball to Connell. And another beautiful ball by Connell. Woofenden. Fullback Thomas backing up. Nice football by Walton. They're playing some methodical stuff here. But they rather gave that one away, didn't they? Except Morris is lucky to pick it up. Smith, a nice one. Edwards. And Connell up there. No, it was the other big fellow, Summers. Very much alike, these two. Summers number 10, Connell number 9. Two big men with long hair, and strangely enough, both male models. That's got to be some sort of a record, of cup final side with two male model strikers. Edwards. Well, this match was poised very evenly on paper amongst all the pundits when they looked at it in this morning's papers, and that's the way it's working out here at Wembley. An even match, neither side getting on top to a considerable extent, but both looking dangerous. Perhaps Walton slightly the more dangerous at this stage. Ray Eaton of England there in possession. Nice little one to O'Sullivan. Heavily tackled there by Thomas. And referee Harry New now must be beginning to wonder if he's got to do something rather firm to get a grip on this game. That's the third Walton man to be spoken to. Roger Day with the free kick. He's clearly taking most of the set-piece kicks for Slough. Tries to take the goalkeeper by surprise, and it nearly came off. But Teal in the end did well. Richard Teal kept his head and used his fullback Thomas. And Thomas kept his head there because there was very little room to squeeze that back to his goalkeeper with O'Sullivan in the way. With the throw for Slough. 10 minutes gone, no score. Anthony did well because he got the throw, although had two men on him. Bassett and Thomas. Anthony won the throw, and that's important in a good position like this. Day has it. Turns it inside, but it's probably gone off a Walton man for a corner kick, so the second corner of the game again to Slough. And they pull back their two big strikers, Summers and Connell, because they need the height of these men in their own box in defence. Day taking it. It's a dangerous one, but nicely nodded back there by Chatterton, but it was already over the line. Good effort, though, by Chatterton. Nodded it back, but it had already gone out of play. Richard Teal, still an amateur, of course, but there's talk this boy might turn professional with Queen's Park Rangers at the end of the season. A promising young goalkeeper, aged 21. Edwards there getting it to his... No, but O'Sullivan nipped in well there. Should run over for a goal kick. As I was saying, this young man, Richard Teal, has yet to pick the ball out of the net in the Amateur Cup this season. Not in seven matches has he had to do so. Summers up well. Morris, nice ball inside, but well tackled there by Alf Darcy. Little bit of aggro there by Edwards when he got that one away. Well, these These two teams were out having a look at the pitch before the match, and they met on the pitch and they shook hands and looked very friendly, but now it's the real stuff. There's not too much friendship showing itself. Another corner. Well, big Mickey Chatterton there had a bit of a chance. Edwards very relieved there on that goalpost that Chatterton didn't get clean away from him. Now, can Slough make better use of this third corner kick? Oh, beautifully taken by Teal. Infringement on him anyway as he went up. But Slough will be disappointed not to have got a strike on goal from those three corner kicks. Roy Thomas there with a little bit of a knock in the head. Morris, a nice ball using Edwards. Summers up, but went too early. Day using the width of the pitch, bringing fullback Eaton into it. He's got Anthony outside him, gives it. Anthony quickly tackled by Thomas. But Eaton again. And it's Woffenden over there challenging. Walton having to mark tight and work hard at the moment with Slough on top. Take the free kick again. Well, Teal was never too bothered about that. I think he saw it was a little too big and a little too wide. But Richard Teal, the busier of the two goalkeepers at the moment. Putting his side in trouble, and it's Reed away there. Heavily tackled by Edwards, and Edwards is going to be spoken to. The fourth member of this Walton side to have some firm words from referee Harry New. It's a good break by Reed there, and it was a bad tackle by Edwards. Ray Eaton taking it. The left flank defender to in-swing it with his left foot. Hurls it in there. And it was O'Sullivan who nearly got a touch there. Alf Darcy. In goes Chatterton against Thomas. Thomas did well under pressure. Nice ball to Woffenden. Looking for his big men, but Walton at the moment not able to find their big men like they did in the early moments. This is O'Sullivan. Free kick to Walton. They'll be pleased to get this kick. They've had a lot of pressure on them and they'll be glad to try and settle in the opposition half of the field for a while. They'll be pleased to have come out of this heavy pressure without conceding a goal, Walton, as Roy Thomas takes this free kick for them. Darcy, not too clever a clearance. Connell in the end getting the header. Oh, good turn inside by Chatterton. Edwards is hemmed in, does well. Beautiful work there by Edwards, and gets it back. It's a nice ball. Was equal to it, and it's a quick break here, but Thomas is there, number two there, doing a good job for Walton. Darcy with the throw. Back to Darcy. Well, fine goalkeeping there by Teal. Brilliant goalkeeping as Chatterton came in there. Morris giving it away. Nice play by Reardon. Finds Reed. Slough the more methodical of the two. Willie Smith robbed there by Day. Let's one go. Trying to catch Teal out of goal. Roger Day, they're trying a quick one, seeing that the goalkeeper was out, but couldn't keep the shot on target. Morris. That's a better ball. Connell doing well, taking them on. Well, that was a very good move there by Roger Connell. He's big and he's brave because he had two men on him there, but he took them on and got in the center, but just a little too oblique and over the top of the goal. Ian Wolst at home, who's not had so much work to do so far, ex-England international, been to Wembley twice with Enfield. Reardon. O'Sullivan won't get that, Thomas is on him. Woofenden backing up nicely, good control. Smith. But this Slough defence is that little bit more on top of the Walton attack than is the other way round, and it's Slough looking the better side at the moment as we come up to the 20-minute mark. Morris given the ball there. Can he make use of it? Again, the Slough defence anticipating better. O'Sullivan. It again. He might be booked here. He's going to be booked. Referee Harry New having little choice there. That's the third time he's had to speak to Dave Bassett of England. And this insurance clerk goes into the book. Furthermore, the Walton captain. Well, referee Harry New there had to do something fairly soon with the large number of quite deliberate free kicks being conceded. And it's Dave Bassett who's been booked, and we wait to see if the two teams have got the message. Reardon's free kick. Darcy lets one go. Alf Darcy there would like to have done a little bit better than that. Good anticipation. Gain. A long one for Chatterton, and Chatterton didn't connect. It rather spoilt what was a good move. Morris, good control, bad pass. Eaton's got no one with him, has to try and go it alone, and well, Woofenden tripped him up there, but referee Harry New decided it was more or less accidental. Just enough intent for a free kick. He's going to have a word with him, though. He's gone over to speak to him. Reardon to take the free kick. Slough getting the pressure on again, but yet to score. It's a bad one. Walton couldn't find number 11 there, who's often free on the left. They're often finding this Dave Morris in space on the left. Well cut off by Day. Bassett having to give it away because his attack had dropped back. Well anticipated by Morris. Finding Edwards, good play. Summers, but Edwards not being able to control it there in that tight space. Ian Reid, another England international, with the throw for Slough, whose back four are looking solid as their England reputation. Reid again. Whoa. A little bit of aggro off the ball there, which nobody saw. Nobody that mattered, that is. Harry New hadn't seen it. Yes, there's a lot of needle in this cup final. Connell nodding it forward there, but Slough again anticipating it all and controlling it most of the time, but not all of the time. Billy Edwards with the throw. Smith there, so it's a free kick to Walton. Now Darcy coming up to organise an early wall. Wolfenden to take it. Two men there to cut off the short ball. Connell and Summers will be up for this one. There goes Connell, but the goalkeeper does well. Connell again, causing all sorts of trouble, but Slough surviving. Can Thomas pop it back in? He does so. Connell again, but Mead up there well. Day has it. Finds Eaton. Eaton's got Chatterton, that's Chatterton. Now he's hemmed in, but so uses Eaton again. Good positioning by O'Sullivan up front there, but again kicked by a Walton defender, probably Donaldson. Yes, it was Donaldson. Another free kick to Slough. Darcy knocks it in. Chatterton can't connect. Again, Lambert lead up strongly, but beaten there. Well beaten by Wolfenden, but Reardon sweeping nicely. Slough in command, but not yet in front. Chatterton gain. Slough fullbacks go wide nicely, but they want to do better than that with their final balls. Reid disappointed with that. Roger Connell at least causing the Slough defence problems, even if not creating clear openings. Chris Lambert with the free for Walton. And it's Reardon getting it away. Thomas. Nice one to Wolfenden. Nicely inside. Bassett has it. Smith. Smith again. Thomas. Chesterton. Alf Darcy. Roger Day. Wolfenden in strongly there. Eaton. O'Sullivan. Chesterton. He lets it go there. Well, at least he had a go, not on target. A good firm shot, though. ball to Edwards. Bassett. Morris won't catch that. Walton getting frustrated when they do win possession in midfield. They're being made to hit these long balls by Slough. Slough marking them tight, making Walton hit these long balls, which the Slough back four are mostly mopping up. The big question, can Slough make better use of the greater share of attacking ball they've been winning? Bassett. Oh, good move. This is Morris. That should be a free kick to Walton for Reed's foul, unless Harry New is going to allow the corner kick. Either way, it's Walton's ball in a good attacking position. Woffenden to take it. Dave Morris organised. Woffenden takes it. It's got to be up for the big man, but too near the goalkeeper. Nicely taken by Walton Home. Chatterton. And it's Woffenden this time. Is he going to be booked? No, not this time. Harry New shaped to take his book out, left it alone. Anthony can't quite catch it. Referee has a word there with Woffenden. Corner kick. Yes, this Walton defence is surviving, but only by use of some slightly dubious tactics. One man booked and several spoken to. Roger Day again with the corner kick for Slough. Beautifully taken by Teal again. And again it's an infringement. As he caught it, he was fouled, so it's a free kick. Oh, Eaton up above Woffenden there, jumping early, free kick against Ray Eaton. Well, a half hour gone, no goals, a few thrills, but mostly a case of Slough getting on top without being able to create enough clear openings. Chris Lambert, plenty of time. Bassett. Summers. Donaldson and Chatterton. Chatterton's got it. He's got plenty of men inside him if he can keep control of it. And it's Gain who's pulled down there. And there's another booking. It's looking like little Willie Smith there. Yes, Willie Smith is the second Walton man in the book. Well, Harry New will be getting a little bit of a problem on his hands at the moment. Walton continuing to give away these free kicks. They've had two men booked and several spoken to. If they succeed in their object by these methods, it's bad for football at the headquarters where things should be done right. Well, Kenny Gaynor's recovered there from that injury, and Roger Day will take the free kick in a very dangerous position. He's got Chatterton outside him for the big shot, and here it comes. Oh, it's a fine shot and a very good save. Very good shot there by Mickey Chatterton. Roger Day just shoved it sideways. Chatterton knew he had to hit the target. He did so, but Richard Teale had it all weighed up. A good piece of football. Toolmaker Roger Day, if he was on overtime in football, would be highly paid, because he's taking just about everything. He's taking the corner now, but not very well. Woofenden. Thomas getting him out of trouble. Woofenden there committing the error of fiddling about in his own box when his team was in danger, but Thomas got him out of trouble. Roy Thomas having a good game. Slough keeping this pressure on. That's Anthony, the Welsh international. Day swings it inside. Chatterton's there, can't get up to it. And that's a foul by Chatterton on Edwards. Big Mickey Chatterton there, 14 stone four. When he hits you, you know you've been hit. Flicking it sideways, but picked up nicely by Reed. Bassett to Edwards. Connell losing it that time. Gain, good football. This is good. And again, he's brought down. This time by Lambert. Lambert being warned. Chris Lambert there. Yet another quite premeditated Walton foul. Their motto is, they shall not pass, no matter how we stop them. So it's up to Slough now to make Walton pay for this by creating something better than they have been with these free kicks. Eaton takes it. Connell. Morris might catch it. Nicely swept across by Redden. Clearing that one up, but rather an untidy ball in the end he gave. Morris with the throw. Rather, Edwards with the throw. Morris wants the throw. Doesn't get it. Connell does. Handballs it in, controlling it. Free kick to Slough. 10 minutes to go to half-time. Slough still on top, but only the one close chance so far. No trouble at all for Richard Teale, that one. Roy Thomas looking for Summers down the right, but cut off. Chatterton, well, he's barging his way through there, takes some stopping. Good ball by Day, and a very rough tackle there by Roy Thomas. He'll be spoken to. Probably hasn't seen anything like this before. Three men booked in the first half of an amateur cup final, and this is Roy Thomas going in Harry New's book. Roger Day's also involved, but Thomas is being brought over for the booking. Well, this is a pity, because the boy's been playing very well, age 20, the youngest player in the side. Harry New pointing out that that sort of tackle just won't do. Day going in, but Donaldson getting it away. Walton surviving, but only just, and certainly not by the most savoury of methods. Bassett, the captain. Good play there by Bassett. He drew Day onto him and won the goal kick of him. Muscle coming towards him as Summers and Connell bore down on him, but he got it away. Roy Thomas with the throw for a Walton side who will be quite pleased to go in at half time, not having conceded a goal, because they've been under quite a lot of pressure. Bassett whipping it in the middle there, but no trouble for Reed. Anthony turning nicely, he's got Day inside him and O'Sullivan outside him, but Donaldson gets it back nicely. Summers controlling it well, but in the end not well enough. Chatterton in space, Lambert a quick tackle, Day. For O'Sullivan, but can't get round Donaldson. Anthony getting round the fullback, who fouls him again, and it's a free kick against Thomas there. Slow his dive down because the ball was rather slow arriving, and he might well have dived over that one. Willie Smith to Edwards, cut out there. Morris has it. Foul against Alf Darcy there. Dave Bassett takes it, knocks it in, there's a chance! Well, there was a chance there for Kieran Summers. In fact, it was Woofenden in the end, another of the tall men. Not usually up there. That was Colin Woofenden, moved up from midfield, threw himself at it. Good run, didn't connect. Good tackle by Thomas. Well, Walton breaking out now as half-time draws near. Walton breaking out of the defence they've had to indulge in for most of this half. And if they were to sneak one now, Slough would be sick indeed. But it's Slough's match at the moment, yet without a goal to prove it. This is Bassett. O'Sullivan nicely tries the chip. Good thinking there by Mickey O'Sullivan. He saw the goalkeeper again had been drawn forward, but chipped it just too strongly. It's Connell. Morris blocked. Roger Day in trouble there. Again getting it away well to Anthony. Nice play by Anthony, the Welsh international. Plenty of men on his right, puts it that way. Well blocked by Morris there. Mead away, but only to Woofenden, who plays it back nicely. A good flick there by Summers, This is good stuff by Walton, the best we've seen from them this half. Edwards, Willie Smith, there's a chance. My goodness gracious me, Kieran Summers, the big Irish boy, should have had that one, and his expression sums it all up. The best chance of the match, and he missed it. Really meaning business now. That's Morris, but Mead sweeping across well. The game will have to stop. There's a Slough man on the deck, not at all feeling well. Okay now, the game can resume as we get to a couple of minutes from half-time. There'll be a little bit of extra time added on in this half for the injuries and the bookings. There's been three bookings and a couple of good injuries. Goal kick to Slough. Roger Connell succeeded there because Walton Hersham's goal kick was inaccurately played off the park and Walton have the throw. Roy Thomas taking it, finding Connell. Roger Day looking for outside left Anthony. O'Sullivan goes across to help. Donaldson lashes it out of play. Walton not taking any chances. Eaton with the throw. Bassett has it. Again, Donaldson just bangs it up there into the terraces. Ray Eaton with a long throw for Slough. Was going to try a short one if Anthony came near, but he was marked. Tries it again. And a clever throw because Bassett had to give away a corner kick to stop it reaching the goal now. The fifth corner of the match for two Slough. What can they make of it? Roger Day takes it. Oh, well punched indeed by Teal. He's had a good game for Walton. This is a good quick break. This is Connell taking on Elf Darcy. Fouls, and Alf Darcy being warned there by Harry New, who made a point of turning around, looking at his number, to let him and everyone know that next time you'll be booked. Roy Thomas with the free kick for one. 45 minutes have gone on the clock. We're in injury time for this first half. And that was Lambert up there. Walton throwing all their defenders in on these occasional chances to attack. They know that their chances to score goals may well be limited. They're having to make the most of them. Well, that is the end of a first half at Wembley. Not over-distinguished in terms of football, but remarkable in terms of the three names that that man, referee Harry New, has had to take. Three Walton men booked, but the score at half-time in an Amateur Cup final, Slough are doing the better, but not scoring. The half-time score, Slough 0, Walton and Hersham 0. second they want, is it? Yep, okay. You know, I've never heard that before. Team booed out at Wembley as they come out. Blimey. You know that very good chance that the big number 10 had there for Walton? He hit it wide, didn't he? He did connect with it. Second half of the Amateur Cup final, the situation being Slough on top but yet to score, Walton with three men booked, and they've got a big job to reinstate themselves with the crowd who booed them back onto the pitch for the second half here at Wembley, something I've never heard before in any sort of cup final. Slough, of course, in the amber shirts and the blue shorts playing right to left now, Walton all in red playing left to right. Edwards there, missing the ball, and throw to Slough. Walton, of course, will be delighted about one thing. They've got this far without conceding a goal, and they may well have a lot more of the remaining 45 minutes than they had of the first lot. But not with mistakes like that, but they're surviving. In comes Day. Darcy knocking it in there, Chatterton and pushing and shoving going on there off the ball, and Harry New says, well, you get on with it because you both did it. This is Thomas looking for Connor. Thomas with the throw, he's got Wolfenden there, puts it over the top, now Wolfenden has it, good move by Walton. They can play football when they want to. Well, someone should have come in near post there. Surely, Walton attacked there. A bit slow not to anticipate what had to be a near post ball the way that Wolfenden was hemmed in there. Thomas with the throw. It's man Connell again, working hard and working well. Not that time. This is Chatterton. Darcy, all the time in the world. Chatterton going wide in this half. Perhaps trying to create a hole in the middle for someone else to get in. Day doing well there against three men. Good play by Anthony, the Welsh international. And again he's brought down. This time it's Lambert. Lambert being warned. Roger Day with the free kick. Well, in the end, it was Lambert, number three, who let it go after a few other people missed it. Good thinking there by Lambert. Good play by Reid. Gain. Kenny Gain. And a quite deliberate foul there by Lambert. Reid to take it again. He's the left flank defender, but he's left-footed, so he takes these kicks on the right to curl them in for Chatterton and Mead there in the back of the box. Well headed away there by Lambert. Foul there by Summers. Handball, in fact. Free kick to Slough. Reardon and Alf Darcy, 6 and 5. Ray Eaton. Locked off by Wolfenden. He's working very hard, number 7 there. It's another corner kick to Slough. Today with a corner. Little O'Sullivan there knocking it. Dave Morris blocking it off, number 11 there, for another corner kick. Scoring corner kicks in this match, 7-0 to Slough, the scoring goals 0-0. The scoring bookings 3-0. Alf Darcy. For the second time in the match, not timing his attempts at goal well. He'll be disappointed with that effort. Oh, good strong work there by Connell. And a good tackle there by Reardon. Nice play there by Smith, but just too far for his outside left. Smith back to his goalkeeper there. We've not seen a lot of that in this match. It's a bad kick there, putting Chatterton in possession. Wolfenden cutting it off again. Edwards. Well, the foul against Ian Reid there, the man who's hurt, insisting that Connell kicked him, but the foul was by Reid. Free kick to Walton. Donaldson taking it. Wolfenden pushing in there. There's a little heading chance there for Wolfenden. Should have done better than that. The foul in the end by Connell on goalkeeper Wolstenholme. But before that, Wolfenden had a heading chance he did well to make for himself, but didn't take it well. Oh, good ball by Chatterton to Anthony. Anthony taking on Thomas. And now he's hemmed in by 3. Walton really getting to their men and cutting the Slough attackers off into little pockets of resistance. Day knocking it in. Chatterton up. And Donaldson did well there under pressure. Thomas. Fouled there by Anthony. Free kick to Thomas. Inside. Oh, good clearance there by Donaldson. Morris Wofford had a great ball, opening it up. Edwards loses it though, robbed by Chatterton. Nicky Chatterton, number 9 for Slough, an active, good player for his side today. Darcy knocking it in, but not accurately. This is gaining space, but again, there's 4 Walton men round him in a flash. Walton to be praised for the way they do mark Titan in great numbers. Not to be praised for a lot of their tackling, which has had 3 of their men booked. Bassett, Smith and Thomas, all booked in the first half. Edwards. Corner kick of the match for Slough. Flick on. Reed. He's got gain outside him. A long one to Chatterton, badly placed. Slough not doing themselves too much justice at the moment. They're winning an off ball, their defence is in control, but they're unable to create anything good enough to get past this ruthless Walton defence. Summers. Free kick to Walton. Fouled by Reardon, who acknowledges it. Wolfenden gone well into space, he's got the header back. Decided it was a little bit of play acting there by Edwards. Morris. Wolfenden again heading this one down. He's doing well in the boxes, Wolfenden, causing danger now for Walton. Somebody might pick up one of these in a moment. And that's another free kick to Walton. Kenny Gain being spoken to on the Slough side. And the chance come up from the Walton supporters here in the crowd. opened and taking it. Knocks it in there for 11, but Roger Day did well to intercept it, and Eaton in the end, but they still have it. Well, nice ball by Edwards. Well played by Roger Day. Thomas has it. And let that one go. Well, good shot there, but it was blocked. But it was travelling. Walton beginning to shape a little bit now. Donaldson. Well, Walton, the younger team, might last the better and beginning to come into the game more now. Going in for that one. Reeve did well to clear it. Edwards pushing forward a lot more now in this half. Edwards. Morris well tackled. Kenny Gain has it. Nice one to Anthony. That's Walton's ball. Lambert, good strong play by Lambert. Connell. Anthony robbed. Anthony. Is he going to let one go? And a very good reflex save there by Richard Teal. Good move there by Anthony, but the goalkeeper had to change direction well and did so. Well, here it is. If he couldn't quite get hold of it. But the big fellow, Roger Connell there, bursting through, and the Slough defence hurt in the process of stopping him. And looks like Keith Mead, who got it there, as big Connell came bursting in. In the first half, but there's a lot more for them to shout about in this second. Roger Day keeping calm but unable to keep the ball in play. Throw for Walton. Oh, it's a good effort there. Good effort there by Kieran Summers. Little back flick with the head, and Wolstenholme had to look lively to get it over the bar. Well, Ian Wolstenholme, age 30, a PE teacher, had to show a little bit of physical education to make that save. With the corner for Walton. They've not had many. They'd like to score from this one. They'll be pouring the big men in on this one, Connell and Summers. Summers up. Gaines knocks it away for another corner. And now the pressure on this Slough team. Kenny Gain there, heading it away for a corner kick, taking no chances. Wolfenden taking it. He's had a good game for Walton. He's worked hard in midfield. He's looked dangerous in attack. It's a chance, and again, they couldn't quite get to it, Connell. Thomas turns it inside nicely to Summers. robbed by Day. Morris. Foul there by Morris on Reardon. And Slough can breathe again as they survive that pressure. Terry Reardon with this free kick. Little chip for Eaton to catch, and he's caught it. Good move. But woofed it in so quick there that Eaton was put off his stride. But Slough still have it. Or do they? And another foul, this time by Reardon. And now he's being warned, and it's Slough having to commit these fouls, as they don't want to see this Amateur Cup final snatched away from them when Passai looked the better side. In his first season with the club and playing at Wembley and taking the free kick. Wuffenden controlling it well enough. Good play by Anthony, getting away from Thomas. And another good piece of play there, but it's Bassett who's fouling there. Bassett, one of the men booked, being spoken to, and have to be careful. A good quick tackle there by Thomas. Throw to Slough. Eaton. Day hooking it in the middle. Chatterton on his own. Turns well. Lambert. Oh, nice play there by Edwards. But again, he couldn't keep the ball in play, but gets applause there from his teammate Summers for a good bit of control. O'Sullivan against Edwards. Roger Connell. And he's... Well, he went up and down there like a... As long as he had the ball, it kept moving. And that's another Walton foul there. It's time by Lambert, who gets away quickly before the referee can speak to him. Wolfenden has it, having to wait for people to take up positions because Walton are all back defending. It's a long chase here for Roger Connell. He can't get round Reardon. Very good play indeed by Reardon. Wolfenden. Well cut off by Eaton. Good positional play. But what can he make of it? There's nobody wide enough. He's having to hold it. Darcy has it. Well, that's given away there by Kenny Gain. Are we going to see a goal here in normal time? It's not looking like it at the moment, but you never know in this game. We could have one, two quick goals. Here's Edwards. Running out of support, marked off tight. Done well to get round the back there. There's a great chance here. A very good chance there, but Summers nodded it back instead of trying it himself. Wuffenden, oh, beating his man nicely, getting round Reardon and winning a corner kick off Eaton. Good play there by the Walton number seven. Colin Wuffenden having a very good game in his first season with the club. Wuffenden! Gareth to take it. They got lots of big men, Walton, on this one. And there they go, but the corner kick really wasn't a good enough one. It was too near to the byline. They've got another corner kick out of it. Wolfenden taking it. Right-footed on the left side, swinging it in. And sooner or later, I've got the feeling that one of these big Walton men is going to connect with one of these corner kicks. Then it's a case of whether Walton Hope will keep it out of the Slough goal. And he had to do rather well to keep that one out. That was Lambert there diving in, number three. Number three there, the Walton number three, nearly getting that one in the net. Well, the third consecutive corner here on this side now, Smith taking it. The goalkeeper doing well again, but another foul, so it'll be a free kick. The foul there by big Roger Connell. When these corners come in, they're pushing and shoving. Connell saying, well, I was only doing what I was having done to me, but Harry New saying, free kick to Slough. Keith Mead taking the kick. Shouted it up strongly. Darcy in there. Again, not able to get it away. Does now, though. Battles well for it. O'Sullivan up, winning the ball, even though he's a little man. Walton have it again. Edwards. Connell. Eaton coming across well. Nearly a little bit slow with it, but he knew it was all right. Bassett winning it. Wolfenden pushing it through there for Anthony, for Morris rather. Dave Morris taking his man on. It's Ken again back helping out in defence for Slough. Well, now in this second half, in the middle phase of it, it's Walton getting on top. An interesting turnabout from the first half trend. Good goalkeeper, out and winning the ball. Gain has it. Having to knock it down there where it's going to be a throw to Slough. Gain to take it. Leaving it to his fullback Reed. One gets the feeling that one goal is going to decide this if we get the one goal. Wolfenden nodding it down well. Darcy in on it. Eaton. Anthony coming inside his man nicely, dummying, sending Eaton down there, but good play by Bassett, the Walton captain. Eaton has got it again. Darcy's got it. Turning it in there for little O'Sullivan, but Richard Teal had read it. Reardon doing well. Willie Smith. To Edwards. Edwards pushing up a lot out of defence this half. Taking Reed on. Reed giving away the throw. Donaldson with the throw. Well punched away by Walton Hersham. Edwards winning it now. Good position. Knocked away for a corner kick, I think. Yes, corner kick, and it's very noticeable in the second half. It's Walton winning the corner kicks. Wolfenden takes it. And again, Slough have to endure the menace of these big Walton men as they come up here now. Again, the goalkeeper does very well, Walton Hersham. And he was in position to save that one. It would have gone wide, he wasn't to know. Well, Walton Hersham surviving the most difficult thing a keeper could have. Out to punch a corner away, down to save the one that's knocked back in. Did well. Willie Smith takes it. Summers up, falls down there. Bassett knocking it back in, but too far. Goal kick to Slough. Chatterton not seeing so much of the ball in this half. Bassett pushing his side forward. Smith has got it. Oh, good move there by Summers. Good positioning. Well tackled by Reardon, though. Chatterton. Edwards is on him. Slough beginning to look a little weary. Have they shot their bolt? Got a few older hands in on their side, might be feeling the pace a little bit on this big pitch, which is renowned for sapping up even the most energetic youngster. This is Summers. He's got Connell inside him. He's got Woffenden inside him. Connell nodding it on. Woffenden, a little flick. Keeping calm, keeping possession. He's got Thomas back here if he can give it to him. Thomas has got it. Doing well. The cross is a corner kick. Off Eaton, and Eaton didn't like it at all. It hit him where it hurts. There's Woffenden, who's been pushing Walton very well forward in the second half. Willie Smith with the corner. Summers up, but Walton up again. There's a chance here for Bassett. Knocked it over the top. Chance, because Walton Hersham, the goalkeeper, was on the floor, but he couldn't keep the chip low enough. To Hugh, Summers. Summers again. Oh, nice play by Smith to send Edwards away, but the referee has already decided, with the help of the linesman, it's a throw to Slough. Chatterton, a good header on, but only to Thomas. Mead. Oh. Reardon clearing. Chatterton battling for it. Well, this is Gain. He's got no sort of inside of him. He lets one go. Good effort there by Kenny Gain. 19-year-old. Let it go well. He saw the goalkeeper come out a little bit. He had no support. He tried a shot, just too high. Again, Day. Day not controlling it. Summers. Connell. Good play by Reardon. Foul against Connell, I think. Free kick to Slough, yes. Right of picture there. Reardon did well in the challenge. Walton Hersham stood up well to his tough tasks he's had lately. Edwards knocking it out. Slough throws. So Slough coming again now. 10 minutes left on the clock, and Slough beginning to come forward again after a really tough time in the first part of the second half. Again, the goalkeeper anticipating nicely. Teal has hardly made a mistake all afternoon. Good. good anticipation by Meade, but Walton have it. Bassett. Chatterton to Kenny Gain if he's got the pace. Reed going down to take the throw. Ian Reed, 29, another physical education teacher, an experienced England international. Chatterton gets up there, but no power on it. Not his fault, he was under so much pressure in the air. Did well to get his head to it at all. Dave Morris to Summers. To Wolfenden. Summers wants it back, but he gets it nicely. And Connell. Connell losing out with ball control there. Cost him gear. Should have done better than that. Good opening, and he spoiled it by losing control. Darcy's not had a very good game today, not by his own high standards. Wolfenden, Connell in there. My, oh, a terrible mistake there by Reed, nearly let Summers in. Summers there nearly presented with the winning goal at Wembley. Got himself out of trouble nicely there. Wolfenden. And now it's Edwards. Willie Smith. Chipped in there. Up goes Walton home. Under pressure there from Summers. And Slough going to make a substitution. Going to bring on Stuart Jameson. Jameson is going to come on now, and they're taking off Alf Darcy there, one of the great names of amateur football, being pulled off. It's understandable, he's 38 years of age, and we're getting towards the end of a grueling cup final, so Stuart Jameson gets his big chance. Kick to Slough. Need to take it. Chatterton. Raiden. Anthony. Back to Eaton. But Walton marking them tight, making life difficult. And the ball knocked out of play. Walton throw. The initiative now with Walton, most certainly in this Amateur Cup final. They've worked hard, they worked unfairly at times, they had three men booked, but they got on top. They've yet to score though, it's 0-0, some 6 or 7 minutes left of play before we move into extra time, and a lot of the players now beginning to look as though they're playing towards extra time, not running themselves out too much, waiting for that extra half hour in which it could all be decided. Anthony. Anthony again. Chatterton going on strongly. Oh, nicely controlled there by Dave Morris. To Summers. Summers dropped by Roger Day. To Reardon. Little O'Sullivan there, doing well in the air, but nobody with him. Summers and Connell getting in each other's way there, enabling Meade to put Slough away. Lambert. Wolf happened, and one of the few players in this game who looks as though he could create something positive and worthy of a goal, Thomas. In they go, and that was a good effort there by Anthony and Connell. I think Connell a little bit disappointed there that Morris rather came in on him. Otherwise, he felt he might have had a free header. Wolfenden nodding it through there. Connell, not having such a good second half, Connell, losing control too often from Walton's point of view. Wolfenden on the ball, had a good game. Willie Smith to Bassett. And that's nicely placed for Edwards, beaten there by Reed. Gain. Kenny Gain putting it on there. Jameson having a run, number 12. Chatterton wins it. He's got 3 men inside him. Here's one of them, it's Gain. To Anthony, and they rather gave it away in the end. The story of this cup final, both defences on top of the attacks most of the time. And Walton survived that one. A good play by Reardon. Roger Day. Roy Sullivan. He's got Donaldson marking him. Try and win a corner here. Oh, he's put it through his legs, and Donaldson had to foul him to stop him. Very good play there by little Mickey O'Sullivan. Time on the clock. Roger Day's free kick for Slough. Oh, beautifully taken by Teal, but not enough pressure there from the Slough attackers. There should have been someone on that. A free catch for the goalkeeper. Smith to Morris. Got Wolfenden inside him. He's got the fullback overlapping. The fullback gets it, Thomas. A good centre. Well, it started off well, then it faded. Goal kick to Slough. Roy Thomas there, booked in the first half, had a tough time, hasn't had so much hard work to do in this half because his team has been more on top. With the throw. Donaldson, the centre-back, pushes up for these long throws. There it is for Summers. Doesn't get his head to it properly. Oh, my goodness me! It's like a Peter Cullender there, and it nearly unseated Slough. They were nearly caught there, very much on the hop, but they survived. Oh, good winning ball there by Lambert. He gives it left. Dave Morris pushes it in there. Good play by Reardon. Chance here, he's hit it. It's there! It's there! Roger Connell has done it! 2 minutes from time. Good play there by Morris. And Connell really hit that one in the one spot that Wilson Home couldn't get it. 2 minutes from time, and Roger Connell has put Walton ahead. Feeling low, they did so much in the first half. They were chopped down by Walton, they kept coming forwards, but Walton have deserved this lead in the second half. They've been the better side, they've done it by fair means and not foul in the second half, and they always look like getting that goal that they've now got, and they've got got a free kick here. Their supporters are convinced the Amateur Cup is going for the first time to Walton and Hersham. Kenny Gain, they're trying to push Slough forward, but Edwards, who's had a strong game down the left there, the story of this Walton win, as it's surely going to be now, is one of strength. It was misplaced strength in the first half when they had three men booked, but they've shown a lot of stamina and heart in this second half. And they're in control now, and Slough trying to pull this game out of the fire, away from the fiery red shirts of Walton. Willie Smith, free kick to Slough. Harry New looking at his watch. It's past the 90-minute mark on the watch. He's playing now the extra time allowed for injuries. Reardon to Roger Day, he's crossed it. Chance for Jameson, the sub. It's well blocked there by Dave Morris. Mead to fullback Reed. Everybody's up now for Slough. That was fullback Reed up there. Corner kick to Slough. This might be their last chance. Might be their last chance ever to win the Amateur Cup. There may be no more Amateur Cup after the next one. They may not get in the next final, which could be the last. We're in injury time. Well punched out there by the... There's a chance here. And Richard Teal, as ever, has survived. This young goalkeeper. Roger Connell, who was beginning to run out of steam, but when his chance came 2 minutes from time, he gave it the big one. He got all his weight behind it, and it was a very good goal, one fit to win the Amateur Cup, which is what it did. Well, there we are. Walton will be unpopular winners to many neutrals here because of their unsavoury tactics in the first half, when they had three men booked, Bassett, Smith and Thomas, but in the second half, they must have won neutral hearts by the strength and character they showed in getting on top. And they finally got a goal we thought we'd never see, from Roger Connell, 2 minutes from time. So that's it. Walton and Hersham win the 70th Amateur Cup final by a score of 1-0 over Slough. So good afternoon from Wembley. Mr. Connell.
Didn't want another 30 minutes of that.
You want any words on this?